Rock and Roll Jeopardy. And here's our host, Jeff Probst.
Hey, guys. Nice to have you here to Rock and Roll Jeopardy. Going to be a good show. Stu, if you would, please introduce today's players.
An architect from San Francisco, California, Brad Roeder. A radio host from Culver City, California, Nicole Sandler. And a musical equipment salesman from Los Angeles, California, Andy Winston.
Welcome, guys. Nice to have you here. It's going to be a good show. Nicole, you know what's up, right? You know what we're playing for.
Big money.
Cash money.
Yeah.
We're talking about De Niro. That's right. Shall we get started?
Yes,
yeah.
Sir.
Light up the board, Kevin. There is one daily double in this round. Remember, your responses need to be in the form of a question. Let's take a look at the categories. Follow the leader. People in song. Tough music trivia. Been there, done that. City madness. Crazy for you. You in quotes means the response will begin with you. Brad, you won the draw. Get us started.
All right, I'll take follow the leader for 100.
Tom Petty and the... Brad.
Who are the Heartbreakers?
You got that category going.
Follow the leader for 200.
Huey Lewis and the... Nicole?
Who are the News?
The News is right.
Follow the leader for 300, please.
Susie and the... Brad.
Who are the Banshees?
Yes.
Stay in this category. Follow the leader for 400.
Rick Nelson and the... Andy.
Stone Canyon Band.
Everybody's on the board.
Follow the leader for 500, Jeff.
Ray Parker Jr. and... Andy.
What is radio?
Nice job.
People in song for 100, please.
Her hair is Harlow Gold, and she's got Greta Garbo's standoff size, but this actress's features made the title. Nicole.
Who is Betty Davis.
Ooh, way to pull it out.
People in song for 200.
This group's 1 week says, like Harrison Ford, I'm getting frantic. Like Sting, I'm tantric. Brad.
Who are the Bare Naked Ladies?
You're right again.
All righty. People in song for 300.
In Give It Away, the Red Hot Chili Peppers call this reggae legend a poet and a prophet. Brad.
Who is Bob Marley?
Yep.
Let's change it and go Crazy for You for 100.
Chris Difford and Glenn Tilbrook of Squeeze were the first acoustic guests when this MTV series premiered in 1990. Andy.
What is Unplugged?
Right.
Crazy for You for 200, please.
In 1991, EMF scored big with this song. Brad.
What was Unbelievable?
You guys are hot.
Crazy for You for 300.
In a hit song from this 1980 film, Johnny Lee was looking for love in all the wrong places. Andy.
What is Urban Cowboy?
Yeah.
City Madness for 100, please, Jeff.
Leroy Brown hangs around the baddest part of this town. Brad.
What is The Whole Damn Town?
No. Nicole, Andy? You're singing it in your heads. What is Chicago? Andy, still your board.
Tough music trivia for 100, please.
This Edwin Starr hit asked, what is it good for? Andy.
What is war?
Yeah.
Tough music trivia for 200, please.
After the departure of Eric Burdon, this group had hits with Lowrider and The World is a Ghetto. Andy.
What is war?
War again.
Tough music trivia for 300, please.
Sunday Bloody Sunday and New Year's Day are songs from this 1983 album. Nicole.
What is Joshua Tree?
No. Oh. Brad.
What is war?
War for a third time, right.
Let's take people in song for 400.
Barry Manilow's lyrics for Bandstand Boogie, the theme to American Bandstand, mention this man. Andy.
Who is Dick Clark?
Yes.
People in song for 500, please.
Well, I hope he will remember a Southern man don't need him around anyhow. Sweet Home Alabama. Andy.
Who is Neil Young?
Nicely done.
Tough music trivia for 400, please.
Marvin Gaye saying, we don't need to escalate. This is not the answer, for only love can conquer hate. Andy.
What is war?
There's a theme in that category.
Tough music trivia for 500, please.
And each time I feel like this inside, there's one thing I want to know. What's so funny about this? Andy.
What's so funny about peace, love, and understanding?
There you go. Nicely done.
Been there, done that for 100, please.
Ben was his first number one hit as a solo artist. Nicole.
Who is Michael Jackson?
Right.
Been there, done that for 200.
Title that completes the lyric, she's got electric boots, a mohair suit. You know, I read it in a magazine. Brad.
What is Benny and the Jets?
Yeah.
Let's take City Madness for 200.
Faith Hill sings, "Hey baby, let's go to this city, bet on love and let it ride." Andy.
What is Las Vegas?
Vegas is right.
Been there, done that for 300, please.
Reinhold Messner, in the title of this trio's 1999 album, refers to a name Darren Jesse used as a teen on Fake IDs. Andy.
Who is the Ben Folds Five?
Wow, yep.
Been there, done that for 400, please.
Once a drifter, his middle name is Earl. Nicole.
Who is Benny King?
You're right.
Been there, done that for 500, please.
He was the Cars' bassist. Andy.
Who is Benjamin Orr?
Yep.
City Madness for 300, please.
It's a video clue. It's the title of the following. Rolling down Imperial
Highway. The big nasty in my side. What is I Love L.A.?
I Love L.A., sure.
City Madness for 400, please.
Nice choice. That is the Daily Double in this round. Now, Nicole, you're shaking your head. It's early in the game. You're okay. Very much alive. How much you want to wager?
Let's bet $500.
All right. For $500, here's your daily double. Mark Cohn claimed he saw the ghost of Elvis in this 1991 hit.
What is Walking in Memphis?
Yeah, nicely done. You're right back in there on True Board.
Let's make it City Madness for $500, please.
According to a Kiss tune, it's where you gotta lose your mind. Andy.
Where is Detroit Rock City?
That's the place.
Crazy for you for 400, please, Jeff.
This Everything About You group chose its name in response to the glam rockers Pretty Boy Floyd. Andy.
Who is Poison?
Nope. Who is Ugly Kid Joe? Brad, just as I was saying it, you knew it.
Yep.
Last one, Andy.
Crazy for you for 500, please, Jeff.
Over the years, Todd Rundgren has performed solo and as part of this ideal band. Andy.
Who is Utopia?
Nicely done, guys. Very good first round. Andy, you got a nice lead, but anything can happen in Double Jeopardy. We'll take a quick break, come back, and learn all about these guys right after this. Gonna meet the players. Brad Roeder from San Fran. What's the deal with the cranberries and a little thievery?
Well, some friends of ours got backstage, and we were back there hanging out with the band. It was the dressing room, and I saw one of the stockings that the lead singer had worn on stage. So I just leaned down, kind of picked it up, and I was real nervous. But then my friend took the other one, so I figured she wouldn't miss a pair.
So the two of you guys, without conspiring, both lifted it.
Yeah,
an entire pair of stockings.
Yeah, I was like, "Look what I got!" And he's like, "I got one too." So.
Well, you're doing pretty well.
Thank you.
Things are going good.
Thank
nice you. To have you here.
Thanks.
Nicole Sandler.
Hi.
Radio host. What kind of radio?
Good music radio.
Right on. Yeah?
Yeah.
You have something very exciting you're in the process of. You're waiting for a phone call.
Yeah, I'm adopting a baby from Russia.
Wow. So are you literally at any moment?
All my paperwork is there. I'm just ready to go over and find her.
Oh, how exciting. Yeah. Well, hopefully you'll have a little
I could use the money,
gift.
So maybe he'll stop answering so many questions and let me win.
Somehow I doubt it. Andy, any chance of that?
I'm laying off, Nicole. Sorry.
Now you're also a musician as
yeah,
well.
I've been playing since junior high school days. So,
really?
Which is many, many years now. So.
When was the first time you thought, hey, I think music's for me?
You know, I was probably 13 years old, and I think I saw Ted Nugent on television, and I said, that's for me, loud guitars and long hair. But
still doing it.
Still
good
doing
for
it.
You. Well, you're doing very well today. But you know what? This is Double Jeopardy. Dollar values are doubled. Nicole, you keep shaking your head. There are two daily doubles. You can catch Andy with a couple of questions.
All right.
Come on.
I'm ready.
Let's take a look at the category, shall we? Eric Clapton. Duet partners. Vibe. Sounds like the produce department. It was 20 years ago. And today. Now, day is in quotes, so day will be in your response. And in duet partners, we'll give you the song, you give us the partners. Make sense? Third goes first, just barely, Nicole, that's you.
Let's start with It Was 20 Years Ago for 200.
He played the Elephant Man on Broadway the same year he released Scary Monsters. Andy.
Who is David Bowie?
Picks up where he left off.
It Was 20 Years Ago for 400, please.
The first U.S. number one hit of the 80s was their Please Don't Go. Who could forget KC and the Sunshine Band? Andy.
It was 20 years ago for 600, please, Jeff.
Michael Ritchie, who directed The Bad News Bears, also directed this 1980 Bette Midler concert film. Nicole.
What was The Rose?
No. Andy.
What was The Divine Miss M?
No. What is Divine Madness? Andy, you're bored.
It was 20 years ago for 800, please.
Oh, a daily double early in this round. Pretty early in Double Jeopardy.
1600, please, Joe.
1600. Fairly decent wager. I respect that. For $1,600, here's your daily double. Fittingly, this hit by Blondie was adopted by the University of Alabama's football team.
Heart of Glass? What is Heart of Glass?
No. What is The Tide is High? And look at that. Just like that, it's a game again. Andy, steal your board.
It was 20 years ago for 1,000, please, Jeff.
Following his success teaming up with Vangelis, John Anderson quit this progressive rock band. Nicole.
What is Yes?
Yeah.
Let's take Today for 200, please.
If you won't give me the time of day, at least give me this funkster, the day of the time. Andy.
Who is Morris Day?
Right.
Today for 400, please.
Entertainment Weekly described the sound of this 1999 Sting album as world beat new age noir. Nicole.
What is Brand New Day?
That's it.
Today for $600, please.
In 1977, Stephen Bishop advised, save it for this.
Brad. What is a rainy day?
Correct.
I'll take Today for $800.
In the title of a Kinks hit, it's when, girl, I want to be with you. Andy.
What is All Day and All of the Night?
That is it. What is All Day and All of the Night? Nicely done.
How about Duet Partners for $200, please, Jeff?
1982, Ebony and Ivory. Brad.
Who were Paul McCartney and Stevie Wonder?
That's them.
Alrighty, I'll take Duet Partners for $400.
1997, I'll Be Missing You. Who are Puff Daddy and Faith Evans? Brad, still you.
Let's go with Sounds Like the Produce Department for $200.
Robin Hitchcock and the Egyptians did a version of this song, subtitled Deo. Andy.
What is Jell-O?
No. What is the Banana Boat song? Brad.
Sounds Like the Produce Department for $400.
Ooh, and a daily double. Game's gotten pretty tight. This is an important wager.
Let's go with $500.
For $500, here's your daily double. She sings Across the Universe on the Pleasantville soundtrack.
Who is Fiona Apple?
Oh, nice job. Tightening up there. Your board, Brad.
Let's take Sounds Like the Produce Department for $600.
This Boston band did a rollicking cover of Simon and Garfunkel's Mrs. Robinson. Nicole.
Who are the Lemonheads?
That's it.
Sounds Like the Produce Department for $800, please.
Shannon Hoon, the lead singer of this No Rain group, died in 1995. Brad.
Who are Blind Melon?
Blind Melon's right.
Let's take Sounds Like the Produce Department for $1,000.
I Had Too Much to Dream Last Night is the biggest hit by this psychedelic group. Andy.
What is a strawberry alarm clock?
No. Close. What are the electric prunes? Brad, you're up.
Let's go with Vibe for $200.
From the cover of the magazine, it's a video clue. Seen here, he was in 1991's Boys in the Hood, which was named for a song he wrote in high school. Andy.
Who is Ice Cube?
That's the man.
Vibe for $400, please.
It's also a video clue. Seen here, he escaped from death row in 1996. Andy.
Who is Dr. Dre?
Yep.
Vibe for $600, please.
Seen here, this Queen Bee made her hardcore solo debut in 1996. Andy.
Who is Foxy Brown?
No. Who is Lil' Kim? It's a tight game. Andy, you're bored.
Eric Clapton for $800, please.
Clapton's first top 40 solo hit was this timely tune written by J.J. Cale. Nicole.
What is After Midnight?
Right.
Eric Clapton for $1,000, please.
Clapton's 1974 number one album, or The Address, where he and the band stayed while recording it. Nicole?
What is 461 Ocean Boulevard?
Yeah, and look at that.
Eric Clapton for $600, please.
George Harrison's wife, Patty Boyd, whom Clapton later married, inspired this Derek and the Dominoes hit. Nicole.
What is Layla?
We found a category you like.
Eric Clapton for 400, please.
It's the crime admitted to in the title of a Clapton hit, but I swear it was in self-defense. Nicole.
What is I Shot the Sheriff?
Yes.
Eric Clapton for 200, please.
Clapton earned this nickname from the applause fans gave him when he changed broken guitar strings on stage. Andy.
What is God?
No.
Brad. What is Slow Hand?
Slow Hand, right.
Let's take Vi for 800.
Did you ever think that Robert was the first name of this Chicago producer and singer seen here? That's R. Kelly. Who is R. Kelly? Brad, still you.
Let's go to Duet Partners for 600.
1983, tonight I celebrate my love. Roberta Flack and Peebo Bryson. Brad, you.
Today for 1,000.
Sweet Tuesday Morning is the British B-side of this 1972 hit, Bad Fingers Biggest. Brad.
What is Come and Get It?
No.
Oh, God.
What is Day After Day? Oh. Tough one to miss. Brad, still you.
Duet Partners for 1,000.
1985, It's Only Love. Who are Tina Turner? Brian Adams. Brad.
Vibe for 1,000.
This R&B crooner seen here used his good voodoo to help the men strike back at VH1's Divas. Andy.
Who's D'Angelo?
Yeah.
Duet Partners for 800, please.
1979, No More Tears, Enough is Enough. Who is Barbra Streisand and Donna Summer? Boy, very tight game, Nicole. You made up a lot of ground. First place is going home with cash, and what else, Stu?
Well, Jeff, our grand prize winner will also receive a $1,000 shopping spree for movies, music, electronics, games, and more, courtesy of the Sony Card. Start turning your spending into everything entertaining with the Sony Card from Citibank, the official currency of playtime. Today's second place contestant will receive a trip from Marriott Vacation Club International. Choose from 42 resorts with 19 destinations, including Park City, Utah, the Four Season Playground, or bask in luxury in Palm Desert, or indulge your senses in Hilton Head. Marriott, the worldwide leader in vacation ownership at vacationclub.com. Today's third place contestant will receive the Party Pack Karaoke System, everything you need for great karaoke entertainment in one compact bag. Fun is in the bag with the Party Pack from Sound Choice. Jeff, back to you.
And our final Rock and Roll Jeopardy category is concept albums. We'll give the players a couple of minutes to make the very important wagers. Be right back. Roll Jeopardy category, concept albums. Players, here's your clue. Director Sam Peckinpah considered making this Eagles album into a movie. You have 30 seconds. Good luck. Boy, I heard an audible sigh from Andy just as the music was ending, like, maybe you made the wrong choice. We'll find out. Brad, first up, currently third place. Let's see your response. Hotel California is not right, but a good guess. What'd you wager? You went for it, as I knew you would. Put you right back to where you started, and you're still in third place. Let's come down to the other end and find out what Andy was so upset about. See your response. Hotel California, nope, that is not right. What'd you wager? All of it. Boy, it comes down to the middle. And you, Nicole, let's see the response.
It's wrong, too.
Hotel California, no. Desperado. Yeah, Desperado is what he directed a lot of Westerns. That talked about the old and new genres of Western. Now the all-important wager. You were smart. Congratulations. $37.99.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Eric Watson.
We have a house minimum at Rock and Roll Jeopardy of $5,000, so we're bumping that up to $5,000. Plus a Sony card.
Nice.
And remember, you can play Rock and Roll Jeopardy online at VH1.com. Come on over, guys. We are done for fun. So long.
Whoever said kids couldn't hang out with the big guys? Rock of Ages is next.